Welcome. The subject of this video is a comparator-based battery charger. I'm your host, Lewis Laughlin. Please visit my website at www.bristolwatch.com for plenty of ideas for hobbyists and junior engineers. This, more than anything, is going to be a lesson in basic electronics circuits. Here we're going to learn not only comparators, but also CMOS logic, switching, and transistors. There are three main goals to this video and project. First, we're not going to use any form of microcontroller. We want to use CMOS parts, and I'll demonstrate interfacing those. And we want to use comparators. Now, when you're charging a lead acid cell, this is what you really have to do. You want to turn on the charge voltage if the voltage on the battery drops below about 12.5, 12.6 volts. You want to charge the battery until the voltage reaches 14.6 volts. Then you want the charge voltage to turn off. The voltage will turn off and stay off until it drops to approximately 12.6 volts. The idea, of course, is to avoid leaving the charge voltage on above 12.6. If you just keep charging the battery and charging the battery, even if it's under 14.6, you're going to shorten the life of the battery considerably. So I'm going to show you a way and learn some electronics and how to get around these problems. But first, let's see a live video of the actual breadboarded circuit in action. All right, what you're looking on this breadboard is an analog battery charger control circuit. It uses no microcontrollers. I measure the voltage and its range by a resistor divider network and an LM339 quad comparator. This, of course, is a dual JK flip-flop, and that's simply an inverter gate. This LED here symbolizes the charge is off. This is your charge on voltage on this LED. All four of these LEDs, of course, are lit up, telling me that we're reading the voltage here, that I've set an input voltage of 14.6. The idea is, when you charge a battery, is that you want the battery to charge up to a certain point. You want the charger to cut off until the voltage drops down to another point. So that's what I'm going to demonstrate here. What you see here coming off this charge LED is a driver transistor, and here's another driver transistor. I don't have the lead acid cell connected in this demo, but it has been tested and it charges it quite well. So I'm going to simulate a battery charge and discharge by connecting it to a variable power supply and reading the meter. As we drop the voltage, you notice one of the LEDs went off, and I want it to drop down. You notice another LED went off. I want it to drop down to about 12.5. Okay, there you go. You notice the charge LED went on. And now if I had a battery connected to it, it would be charging. And I want the charge LED to stay on. Notice it over here and watch the meter. I'm going to increase the voltage. Again, you see one of the four LEDs over there lit up, but the charge LED is still on. I'm approaching 14.6 or so, and there it went off. Let's look at that again. Battery fully charged, the charge voltage is off. Let's drop the voltage again as the battery in real time would be discharged. And it should trip on about 12.6, 12.7. And there you go. The charge voltage is on again. And the charge LED here will stay on until I go back up to about 14.6. Off it goes at around 14.5, 14.6. Let's take a closer look at the schematic and discuss the circuit itself, how it works. All right, a few last things to note before we move on to the schematics. This is a 100K potentiometer. It allows you to set your trip points broadly, as you can see here. I can change the trip on and trip off voltage. In this case, I lowered it down to 11.7 at the bottom. And fully charged it around 13.7. You can also note there's a group of resistors that is used with the... You'll see them in the schematic, that's used with the LM339 quad comparator. Varying the values on those slightly will also change your spread between on and off. Alright, let's move on. Alright, we just saw the video. Let's do a brief rehash of what a comparator does. This happens to be an LM311 comparator that has an open collector output. What I have here is when it switches on, let's look back here. For argument's sake here, I have V reference on the plus input, and when the voltage on the minus input exceeds V reference, pin 7 through an internal transistor will switch to ground, turning on the LED that you see here. Now, if its VN is less than V reference, and of course the transistor will be turned off, and this 4.7K resistor allows the output to float high to VCC, in the case here of 12 volts. So again, we're pulling the output high through the 4.7K resistor, and the LED will indicate that the output transistor is turned on and switched to ground when it lights up. VN must exceed VREF to turn the LED on. All right, here's a partial schematic of the main battery charger circuit itself. I have cut the comparators down to just two for illustration purposes. Let's look at what we have here, of course. The two that I'm using, there is a 1K resistor between their respective plus inputs, and this operates sort of like a window comparator. Okay, let's look at the rest of the circuit here. This is the 12 volt battery to be charged. You have to connect the battery into the circuit before anything will operate anyway. We have a 5-volt 3-pin regulator here, and make sure you have that 10 microfarad cap that feeds 5 volts to this comparator circuit. I'm not running the comparator circuit at 12. Instead, I'm running with a regulated 5 volts. Because if I didn't do that, as the battery voltage charged and discharged, it would change the trip points on the comparators. But what I did do is from the 12 volts, I connected a 10-volt Zener diode. So 10 volts will be dropped here. And this test, and the only thing I will be seeing through this 100-ohm resistor here is 0 to 5 volts. As far as the charging goes, I'm only interested in that voltage range from 10 to 15 volts anyway. So I used the Zener to drop the 10, and now I have 0 to 5. Here is the potentiometer. I went ahead and took the remaining resistors and made it a 3K resistor. And here is my 1K resistor here. So if you, depending on the value of the 1K resistor, you can vary it. We would want this thing, we would want B to turn on. It would go low, switching on the LED at about 12.5, 12.6. and we would want A to switch low at around 14.6. Now you notice we have two outputs from here, A and B. Note that this here is a 5-volt circuit and that the 10-volt Zener diode delivers only 5 volts at the most, unless your battery goes to 18, 20 volts, then you're in real trouble. But nonetheless, the comparator is set at a regulated 5 volts, and we're measuring 0 to 5 volts, and the voltage trip on and spread in this window, basically modified window comparator circuit, is something like, 2 volts. Actually, I ended up using the third, which would have been the third op-amp comparator, the third LM339, which has 4 comparators in the package anyway, instead of B, but I'm going to illustrate it as A and B. Okay, this is the second half of the battery charger. These pins obviously go back to U1A and U1B. When the voltage drops below 12.6 or so, both U1A and U1B are switched off, and their outputs are pulled high by these 4.7K resistors. That indicates what that does is it produces a low output here, which is inverted to a high output here, and it clears this JK flip-flop with a high out of Q-nut. The high out of Q-nut will forward bias the base emitter junction of Q3, which will switch Q3 on, and the current flow from this case on this side here is your solar panel, will switch on the current from the emitter base through Q3, switching on the voltage from the solar panel to the 12-volt system, which includes the battery. All right, when it charges up fully, it's going to be looking now for this here. When it goes low, that means the fourth LED in the string that you saw in the video is going to turn on, which is an indication of a low. That low is inverted through U2C. This is just being used as an inverter. It's going to go high, and it's going to set the JK flip-flop. So Q is going to go high. This is your charged-up LED. Q-naught's going to go low. Q3 turns off. Q2 current turns off. And D1, the charging LED, of course, turns off. And that's pretty much it. What it's doing, it's sitting here, it's just using the JK flip-flop as a 1-bit storage device. It's either going to be Q high and Q not low, or Q1 low, Q high and Q not low, whichever. These are always the opposite state. This assures us that this circuit will switch on at around 12.5, 12.6, but when it hits around 14.6, this circuit up here will turn off the system and wait until the voltage drops again. There's your basic lesson in electronics and another novel use for comparators. By the way, the CD4093, which is these NAND gates, have Schmitt trigger inputs. This helps assure clean operation if the signals get a little funky or messed up, or even at 5 volts. So there we go. I hope this was useful to you. Visit my website at www.bristolwatch.com. Have a great day.